Ladies and gentlemen, from Canada, Kurt Browning.
He says his secret weapon is Sandra Bezek, who always gives him the tools. She's the one that came up with this idea, which I think perfectly suits him.
In that performance. Kurt Browning in Kitchener. He never stops, even off the ice. This is Kurt Browning. Classic Kurt.
What a brilliant idea this one was. This suits him so perfectly.
Caught myself staring at the nose on the toes. That was good.
And Elvis, one of the things, even though it's a humorous comedic routine, is the difficulty involved in so many of these steps.
It's incredible because all of the jumps that he's done is out of a step sequence and there's no preparation. And right here's classic example. Double axel out of nowhere.
And every one of those jumps hit the perfect note in the music. They all enhanced the music perfectly. That was great. But I loved the ending. I thought the ending was unbelievable. How risky. Like, he could have ended up on a judge's lap. I mean...
You know, these ISU judges don't know what they got themselves into.
Look at that. I mean, he could have landed on that computer right there. It brought down the scores.
Yeah.
He keyed into those own marks, maybe. I think we all know what the marks are going to be.
This is what the interpretive free skate is all about. The marks, use costume, use different moves, and humor.
Whoa. Oh,
holy 5.8.
What can you say?
5.9.
He's a genius. He is a skating genius.
How would you like to be Michael Weiss? A 6.023.
Four
of them.
That was awesome.
I was going to say, how would you like to be Stephen Cousins, who skates next, and Michael Weiss, and have to go home
thank
tonight
you,
and say you got beaten
you,
by
Michael.
A clown?
Thank you so much. That was so much fun.
But, you know, Stephen Cousins' routine is also
a little clowning around
in just a moment
in the Kitchener Memorial Auditorium Complex. $40,000 for Kurt. Earlier in the day, he was in second. Tonight he's the king again. We'll speak to him after this. Kurt Browning does it again. 4 years in a row, winning this event. Of course, it's open this year, and he beats Michael Weiss coming from behind in the interpretive free skate tonight in Kitchener. Let's go downstairs to Rob Falls.
Well, he said the spontaneity was gone, and he's being spontaneous. Now, tell me about this program. Is this a germen of an idea that you had? It's not one of those things you can't find the music for, can you? And then to develop a program after?
It worked this way. Stars and Ice is doing a clown number this year, and so Michael Siebert and Sandra Bezek are the choreographers for Stars and Ice. So they're always looking for music for the show, and they found Michael Siebert found this piece of music and thought it might be good for me when I do Stars and Ice. So Sandra and I put it together, and that's how it happened.
Did you expect the kind of reaction you got from the crowd?
Well, the real test will be when I'm not in Canada. And if people laugh in the United States and in Europe, then that will be the real test. They're very forgiving here, and they love the Canadian skaters with all their hearts, as they've shown so much support here in Kitchener. And so I was nervous, really nervous. But the character's so much fun, and no rules, you know.
You've owned this competition. Congratulations.
Oh, it's been fun. Thanks, Sandra. Thanks, Michael.
I'm amazed. That was so different. My God, who had this idea?
This idea is going to be a part of the Stars and Ice show in April. And so Michael Siebert is a choreographer with Stars and Ice. He found the music, and Sandra Bezek and I put it together. So this will be my Stars and Ice number, but we thought it might be fun for competition, and we didn't really know how the judges would react, and with no lighting or anything, how it would go over. And it's the first time I've done it, and I'm very excited that it went well. It's scary to, you know, to actually dress up like a clown and try and be funny. Yeah. It's scary, but it was fun.
And you have to be very sync. And you told me a minute ago that you were not perfectly sync, and it didn't appear on TV. You were perfectly sync on TV.
A couple of small things where I wasn't on the ice where I thought, and the ending is very important to be jump on the boards at the same time. And if you don't do that, it kind of, the icing isn't on the cake. And when I was hitting the boards with the music, I was very relieved.
Well, the icing was on the cake.
Yeah.
Bravo thanks. Again.
And the cake was on my face, just like it should be.
Poor clown. Yeah. Merci, Kurt. Alors, Kurt.